sending out a message to the public and to the government of Uganda to deploy interns. I don't see what wrong we've done.
Chaotic scenes have been witnessed today at Mulago as medical interns carried out a peaceful march to parliament demanding for their unpaid allowances. Carrying placards, some demanded to be deployed.
Deploy us now.
We are representing interns.
Yes.
People who have studied for 5 years to serve Ugandans.
Yes.
Us not doing internship means no license.
Yes.
We've started to serve.
Yes.
We've started to work on people.
Yes.
You don't have the right to stop me.
Yes.
That's why I'm fighting for you.
The medical interns were intercepted as they approached the women's hospital in Mulago, and two of them were arrested during the scuffle. There was heavy deployment, and during the interception, some journalists were pepper sprayed.
Those are journalists. You spray the journalists. I found that you're spraying journalists.
Medical students say that they successfully completed their education in February last year, but the Ministry of Health has failed to deploy them for internship. Yet internship is a mandatory stage for the graduate medical personnel.
We have been waiting to be deployed in April 3rd. We have been eagerly waiting, but we are surprised, like around 1st April, by a letter from the Director General of Health Services, Ministry of Health, telling the hospital directors that internship has been postponed for 2 weeks for reasons they didn't tell us.
We should also discuss and streamline medical education and training in Uganda and ensure that there is always proper planning in advance for the number of medical interns plus their allowances, and thus avoid delays in deployment of this critical human resource, and to also avoid the wastage and misuse of human resource, that is of medical interns and medical doctors, that is so greatly needed in this health sector in Uganda.
The medical interns and the senior health officers also want the government to clear their salary and allowance arrears.
Minister of Finance doesn't have money, so they will not pay senior officers and interns. Guys, a survey done by Uganda Medical Association showed that 70% of the workforce, 60 to 70% of the workforce in which these interns and senior house officers are, is given by this crucial workforce of interns and senior house officers. Why are we undermining them? We have had, still, a group of intelligent people went, sat in the air-conditioned offices and said, you know what, I think we shouldn't pay these guys. What they need is accommodation and food.
Once you have got a medical officer special grade going to a hospital, that place automatically becomes an internship training center, period. So promote them, deploy them. Most of these guys want to be in Kampala, but they're not in a hurry. Just give them a contract of 2 years. Send them to Nyachibare, send them to Moroto, send them wherever, and pay them. They will go, and because they're fresh from school, I can assure you they're going to train these interns to the best. They will supervise them.
Despite the tensions surrounding the march, the leadership of the medical fraternity managed to hand over their petition at parliament to the Commissioner Solomon Silwanyi, who represented the speaker.
Under which article?
The statement put out by the Ministry of Health recently clearly indicated that there will be a delay in internship placements due to ongoing consultations. Report by Juliet Namoya for the news.